Hi, welcome. I'm dyeing my hair, so you get to see another creative process. Welcome to the studio. I'm so glad you guys could join me today. I've been working at an art and craft supply store, a scrapbooking store, so I haven't been able to do much in my studio except for the courses I'm teaching online, but I wanted to actually enjoy a couple hours today and just play in the studio and hope you can join me. Marco says my sound is low, but my monitor says it's pretty good, so I don't know. But I just wanted to play. I got some new supplies and I've been enjoying them so far, and I wanted to invite you in to come create with me. So create in your space or watch along and then try creating later. Maybe I'll show you some new technique that you don't know of, hopefully. But we're just here to play and have fun. So welcome, welcome. And if you're watching on Facebook and the Art Journal Junkies group, you can go into the chat and comment on anything or ask anything and I'll respond back. If you are watching on my website, just send me a message through there. There is a contact me page, and then I will respond to you when I can this week. So are you ready? My desktop's a little messy because I just kind of gathered the new stuff and threw it down. And so it's new and old, but you'll see. I'm gonna flip you down. So here we go. This is my desktop. I'm just gonna move a few things over. So now that I work in a store that sells all these wonderful supplies, it's a little hard to refrain from buying some and trying them out, because then I can actually answer the questions truthful, honestly, right? Because I have firsthand experience with them. So I have bought a few of the goodies and I'm quite enjoying them, and I'm hoping to be teaching in the store soon with them. Hi, Laurel. Do you like my hair dye? I have to wash it out later. I decided I'd leave it on for now because the longer you leave it on, the more intense the color is and the longer it'll last. So that's why I did this. And my time is limited. So this is some of the new Art by Marlene paper. That's one of her old last season journals and die cuts. If you haven't seen these, they're pretty cool. I've been using this one in my new journal a bit. I've been playing with some of the new stamps and stencils. You can see I've already christened them with ink. And the leaves, I've used just a little bit. So I'm just gonna put them over the side and then come back to them as we use them. This is the journal that I posted recently that I started my hand-bound. But I don't want to put a lot of other people's work in this one. So I'm not going to work in this one today. Another day we can work in this one. So it has a little bit. Oh, I did try two new things. There's these texture plates by Stamperia. And so I bought this one that's like rivets. And I put this paste in. So I don't know how I'm going to use that yet. I might use it on a cover of a book because you can like bend it and shape it. And then this is from Lawn Fawn. I got their Magic Iris die. So it cuts out all the pieces to be able to do that. So I want to incorporate that somehow in my journal. I'll put those back in there for now. And that's my binding for those that like binding books. Okay, so what I thought we would do is play with some of the stencils and die cuts. And I made some prints of my own past journal pages that we can cut up and put into new pages. This is what I've been doing. Okay, so new goodies that I got. Yesterday I got the 6 new dilution paints. Recently I've got this new brush from Pink & Main. It's called the ergonomic brush. Those are bristles. They're so tight. See if it'll focus. It's just so smooth. It feels like a sponge. But that's what I've been using to blend the stencils. Like, this is my cloud stencil I did on there. And then I painted and then stenciled over top using that brush. So this is just me testing everything out. This one was last. No, this one was this morning. This was last night. So those ones are die cuts from that book, Art by Marlene. And then this is one of the rice paper tissues that I tore off. So I just put her in there. And yeah, and I thought we could do some of the same using Marlene's pieces, using some of mine, so you guys can see how you can use your own. You just go to your local print shop. Like, I go to Staples here and do some color prints of my work. You can enlarge them and all that. Oh, and these are new. They're paint, and it's glitter paint, and it dries really matte. And I use those like here. I use them on a few spaces. I use them here. I use the pink one on here. So it still gives off the shine and the glitter, but my pages are not sticking together, which is awesome. So that's why I like those. I bought two to test, and then I went and got more because they were wonderful. So, oh, and this book that I have, in case you were wondering, it is a Midori Traveler's Notebook. I actually taped over that part or painted over that part. It's an A5 and it's blank. I get them on Amazon. It's about $17 Canadian on Amazon.ca. Okay, time to create. Here. Go into a bit of a shadow here. Oh, it's because I moved the mic. I'm gonna move the mic back. That's better. Okay, let's get some paint on. So those are the new fluorescents. Actually, I'm supposed to have them the other way. We put them all out in the store yesterday, and we were putting them like this. And notice the labels are upside down because we're supposed to have them standing on their caps. All the things you learned. This way, the air bubble will be at the top, and I can squeeze the paint quicker. And I have changed my studio around, so things are in different places. I think I want some teal paint. I haven't totally put everything back in this room yet. It's still out on our dining table. I promised it will be done by tonight, so I have to finish putting the room back by tonight. So if you have any suggestions on colors or ideas of how to lay the page out, feel free to jump in and leave a comment in the chat because I can see it's working. These are some old brushes. My other brushes are out there in the other room. Okay, let's get some of this green. Think I might try some stripes on this page. So this one is a satin finish acrylic paint. Just remember to stay away from regular gloss acrylics because your pages will stick together. These new ones by Dilutions, they're not gloss. The new Dina Wakely ones are gloss, but I haven't bought any of those yet to try. But apparently, they have the gloss finish, but your pages again will not stick. It's some new formula. These books are great because you can do watercolors on the pages as well. The only thing it does not work well with is ink pads and some like alcohol ink markers. Well, all alcohol ink markers, really. But yeah, the ink pads do go through. Wow. Maybe this, I haven't opened this one yet. Let's try this one. I'm horrible with my brushes. This is why I use dollar store brushes. Maybe I didn't mix it up. It's not very opaque paint. So it's really good for layering more so than area coverage, whereas golden totally covers. I think I'm going to do stencils and then we can do some stamping of that over top of it because then we'll have enough layers that the ink will be blocked from going through the other side. I really like this one. So I'm going to show you how that brush works. It's so cool and so much better than all the others that I've had. So I have Forget Me Not by Lawn Fawn. I have these little ones. Actually, I have more big ones. I'll have to get them up for next time. I might do the peacock feathers. See how that looks. To make sure I'm in view for everyone. This is my little ink pad. And this is the brush. And I'm just gonna rub it on there. Twice we've gotten these in the store and they sold out in 2 days because they are so good compared to like the ones with long handles. You just don't, if you have arthritis or that, you're not hurting your wrist or carpal tunnel. This is so good. And it's not leaving streaks. Sound like an advertisement. I just like it. Isn't that cool? And it's just, it's so nice. Let's get the leaf one. I'm gonna try my black ink pad. Could do that one actually. Let's do that one. I haven't tried it with the stays on ink pad yet. This is an older ink pad. It seems a little gummier. Just could be that it's old. I've had it a few years. But it's still pretty cool. That looks awesome on screen. She has a funky bird. Maybe I should put her bird with my bird. Can't remember which book it's in though. There's that one too. We could do three birds. I never used to use other people's products in my books because I always felt like I had to keep it solely mine. And it's like this new freedom I've given myself that I can add other people's work. As long as you don't sell it, right? Fussy cutting. Sometimes I have the patience for it, and sometimes I do not. Because of my colored background, it would just take too long with my scan and cut. He just looks so not amused. Do you print your images on regular copy paper? I took them, my actual journals down to a local copy place called Staples here, and I used their printers and printed onto their color paper. When I'm doing them to sell, I get them done at an actual printer's. An actual, like, a business one, not a mass big box kind of place. Something is missing. We need like some funky quote or something. We can add that later though. See more of a contrast there. They're just so funny. This is my Nouveau Deluxe Adhesive Clear Drying Glue. I didn't put him over the crease because I figured after a lot of wear and tear he'd get kind of mangled maybe. So put him there. I have a story to tell these three. They've been off on some kind of adventure. I'm just looking through some of their stencils I have over here. Could do some cloud ones there too, though. But I got a cool grass one. Let's do some clouds. Clouds. Could balance it out by doing pink clouds from the colors of the birds. This one is Picked Raspberries. Let's see how it looks. This was a meme, what would it say? What quote or saying can we add to this? It's like they've all had a night out that they'd rather forget. What do you think they're saying, Sarah? Oh no, you didn't. It's like they've come back and told this one something that they did. It's like, I can't believe you did that. Making it look like it's raining just on this one bird. Mr. Gloom. Just that's all it needs to say, isn't it? It's just really. Oh, see, now if I brought my big shot in here, I could cut those letters out. I'm gonna do like a word bubble. This is Bristol. Bristol. 100-pound Bristol paper. Sorry. I keep taking it off camera. Muck that side up. I have ink on my fingers. Vintage photo. I'm gonna see if I can easily just do the edges of the word bubble. Trying to look at the layout and see how I should have it. My favorite pen. Make sure I have ink in it before. Almost out. So I don't want to get partway through my word and then it's not good. This is my Pentel brush pen. Really? Glue. Now I want my Sparkle Pop pen, if I can find it. It's almost empty. Oh, that might be cool. I may do it kind of grungy and then go back in with my Sparkle Pop. Because we need to make our birds stand out from the background. Smith. This is my water reactive pencil. So that's my Aquarelle Stabilo. That's a fine tip. I don't want a fine tip. Let's use this. No. Let's use this one. So I need something dark over here to balance this, I think. And then we can add some glitter. Maybe the leaves. Let's do the leaves. Just trying to get in certain leaf shapes. This one is my gold sparkle pop, but it's almost empty. I wish you could just buy a case of the gold. I don't really use the other ones that much. But I'm going to have to. And what I'm writing on here. What happens in the treetops stays in the treetops. Anybody finds a good, reasonable place to buy just a bunch of gold sparkle pops? Please let me know. She's dead, Jim. Right at the end. No more gold. Drained or dry. Hi, Mandy. Hello from Louisiana. Welcome to just outside Vancouver, BC, Canada. So there we go. We did a page of birds. What happens in the treetops stays in the treetops. Now I'm on a mission to find more gold pens. So I'm glad you're here, Mandy. Sorry you're coming in at the end. Thank you to everyone that popped in to say hi. I think we need to try and do this again almost every Tuesday. I won't say every Tuesday because it doesn't always work out that way because life happens. But we'll try and schedule a bunch of Tuesday afternoons from 2 to 4 or 2 to 3:30, which it's almost 3:30 now, and I really need to go wash this hair dye out. But I'm so glad you guys joined me. I hope you enjoyed it. And yeah, let's play again next Tuesday. I will see you here. Next Tuesday, same time, same place. Have a wonderful week. I wish you guys all the best and go be creative and have fun. And I'll see you all again really soon. Thank you for joining me. See you later. Bye. You're saying it's hard to hear me. Here, I'm gonna pull. Is this better? Is this better? Is this better?